common model in game theory is called an assurance game. The assurance game captures situations in which moving from one equilibrium to a much better one requires trust, and trust often depends on information that isn't available. Here's an example. Suppose two strangers, Tom and Jerry, have just escaped from prison in the outback of Australia. Tom and Jerry are starving, and each sees a couple of rabbits and a kangaroo. If they go their own way, each can easily catch a rabbit and live to fight another day. But if they coordinate, they can trap a much faster and larger kangaroo and have enough food for a few days. If one goes for the kangaroo while the other traps a rabbit, the kangaroo chaser goes hungry. This is an assurance game, and it has two equilibria. Both chase the kangaroo, or both chase the rabbit. Think about it this way. If both were to find themselves in the kangaroo square, neither would have any incentive to change his choice. They'd each get less meat by chasing a different animal, and so each would be worse off. The same goes for the rabbit square. If both are there, neither is any better off changing his choice. If Tom stuck to the rabbit and Jerry went after the kangaroo, Jerry would go hungry, and vice versa. Notice why the two other squares are not equilibria. If, hypothetically, Tom has selected rabbit, Jerry would clearly not select kangaroo, since by changing his choice to rabbit, he'd be better off. Likewise, if Jerry has selected rabbit, Tom would never select kangaroo, since it would mean he'd go hungry for the night, given the stipulation that kangaroo can only be caught by two people hunting cooperatively. The assurance game is odd because there are two equilibria, and yet one of them is clearly better for both players. So we might wonder why they don't end up chasing the kangaroo every time. It's worth remembering that players in a game can only choose strategies, not outcomes. Even if both are better off chasing a kangaroo together, this doesn't guarantee it will happen. In the real world, communication can help the players coordinate on a strategy, but communication can be unreliable. To paraphrase the French general Talleyrand, language was invented to conceal our thoughts. Our words don't always broadcast our intentions with perfect transparency. Maybe Jerry's experience in prison gives him reason to think Tom is sadistic, impulsive, or risk-averse. The payoff dominant strategy, in which both chase the kangaroo, may not materialize since both know that by chasing the rabbit, they'll at least live to hunt another day. Assurance games illustrate just how weak the Nash equilibrium is as a solution concept for games. Finding equilibria tells us something about stable patterns of interaction, but it doesn't give us a way of predicting what rational players will do, except under very specific conditions. A final distinction worth mentioning is the difference between games that feature simultaneous choice and games involving sequential choice. Here's an example. Suppose you go to a college at which, sometime before graduation, the cool kids are expected to run naked across the quad. You and a friend decide to do it. But you each think that, although it would be fun to run together, it would be humiliating to do it alone. If you live in separate dorms and agree to show up to the quad naked at midnight, you may worry that your friend won't go through with the plan, and you'll end up naked and alone. As the former president of the University of Virginia said in explaining their nudity policy, the difference between having a good time and getting arrested for public indecency is how many people show up. In the simultaneous choice game, enough risk aversion and uncertainty may lead both players to stay home in their pajamas rather than risk a charge of public indecency. Here's what it would look like in a payoff matrix. Suppose going naked together gives both players 100 points, and staying home is neutral, so they stay at zero. Streaking the quad alone yields the humiliation payoff of minus 50, but it also gives the other player plus 50 because he finds it funny. In a game of sequential choice, on the other hand, the second player will do whatever the first player does. This is because if an outcome is best for both of us, and the only thing preventing us from achieving it is uncertainty about each other's motivations or commitment, once one of us sees the first person make a move for the preferred outcome, the other follows suit. In this case, if Tom runs naked, Jerry sheds his clothes too, and they both get 100 points. However, if Jerry knows that Tom has no intention of going naked, Jerry will stay home to avoid the humiliation payoff. Who goes first will likely depend on who has more guts, so the first mover in a sequential assurance game will determine what the other player does.